What's up, YouTube? This is Thomas from Thomas Invest and thank you for watching. Today I want to talk about some stocks that are a buy opportunity in my opinion. In this video, I will show you how this stock performed recently, the things you should know and why I think this stock is a buy right now. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to get notified when I'm posting a video. I also appreciate an early thumbs up, which helps me within the YouTube algorithm. For now, let's dive into it. The first company on my list is AbbVie. AbbVie is a drug company with a strong exposure to immunology and oncology. The company's top drug, Humira, represents close to half of the company's current profits. AbbVie has a 196 billion market cap and did almost 46 billion in revenue in 2020. The reason why I think this is an interesting company is because of three reasons. The first reason is the recent drop in stock price because of some negative news. If we take a look at the 5-year stock price, we see that it has come up and down quite a bit. This has also to do with some negative and positive news. We also see that since the RoniRoni virus, the stock has come up quite a lot and it's near their all-time high. If we zoom in on the 1-year chart, we see that the stock has gone up almost 50% since the lowest point, which was the end of October 2020, all the way up to the end of August 2021, right before some negative news. Shares of drug maker AbbVie went down 12% following a decision from the FDA to require a heart risk warning on the label of its arthritis treatment, Rinvoq. Many investors did not like this news, so they sold, as we see in this 6-month chart. So, you can look at it two ways. Personally, I don't see this as a problem for the company. The company feels comfortable in their products and has said that this wouldn't change the medicine. It's only a label, which they already knew. But that's just my opinion. The stock price could do something different. I think a lot of people got scared and sold the shares based on this news. I think this was an overreaction. And this was an interesting buy opportunity at that time. I even made a video about this news, which could be found in the description. People feel comfortable owning shares of AbbVie because of several reasons. One of them is the steady business, and I personally also love the dividend. A lot of people sold the shares, but honestly I think this was just panic and not the smartest move. As we can see here, the stock has already gone up 4.5% in the last month. People have faith in AbbVie and I really like the dividend. The second reason why I like AbbVie stock is because of this dividend. In this chart we see that AbbVie pays a dividend at 4.7% yield, at an annual payout at $5.2 a share. A payout ratio of 41%, which is great. This gives the company enough room to buy back shares, do acquisitions, pay down debt and even R&D. The dividend is growing 18% in the last 5 years and has grown for 8 years in a row. In a few days there is the record date, meaning buying shares before this date will allow you to receive the dividend payment. The last reason why I like this company is because they are undervalued. I used my stock price target where I calculate the 5-year average free cash flow, used a mid multiple of 20 representing an average growing company. AbbVie has a current market cap of 196 billion. Where I believe they should have a market cap of 233 billion, meaning this company is undervalued by 19% and has a fair value of $132 a share. Right now they are trading around $111 a share. With these three reasons in mind, I think AbbVie is a great company that could be owned for several reasons. I currently own shares of AbbVie and I'm still expanding my position by adding more shares. Next company on my list is Tyson Foods. Tyson Foods is the largest US producer of processed chicken and beef. It's also a large producer of processed pork and protein-based products. Tyson sells 86% of its products through various US channels, including retailers 48%, food service 28%, and other packaged food and industrial companies 10%. In addition, 14% of the company's revenue comes from exports to Canada, Mexico, Brazil, Europe, China and Japan. The reason I choose this company is because I currently don't own any shares, but I think they are undervalued, pay a solid dividend and has a strong market position with revenue growing every year. Tyson Food is a 29 billion market cap company with a PE ratio of just 12, which is very low and already indicating that this company could be undervalued. But let's take a look at the stock price first. In this 5-year chart, we see that the stock has come up and down quite a lot and is still recovering from the all-time highs right before the RoniRoni virus. They went already 50% up since their lowest point in March. So congrats to all the people that stuck to this stock or bought some shares back then. But I still really do like them at current prices. The next thing I like about this company is again the dividend. They pay a 2.3 dividend yield and an annual payout ratio of $1.78 a share. They have a payout ratio of just 23%, which is incredible. There is enough room to grow this dividend, pay down debt, buy back shares, do acquisitions, and some research and development. Tyson increased their dividend for 9 years in a row and have a 24% growth rate over the past 5 years, so this looks all great to me. The last reason I like Tyson Foods is because they are undervalued by 30% in my opinion, as we see in this chart. Right now they are selling around $79 a share, and I think they have a fair value of $102 a share based on the 5-year average free cash flow. I think Tyson is a great stock to own because they are still undervalued and pay a nice solid dividend. I also don't worry about the business. The revenue is still increasing every year and we all have to eat some food, right? The last company on the list is Sony. Sony Corporation is an electric business unit and the parent company of Sony Group, which is engaged in the business through its 4 operating segments: electronics, including video games, network service, and medical business; motion pictures, music, and finance service. What I love about this company is that they have a PE ratio of just 13, and the revenue increased 20% since 2016. The profit is up even more. Sony is also buying back shares, which means you will own more of the company in ratio, and your share becomes more valuable every time Sony buys back shares. The EPS also will go up, which attracts other investors as well. Sony has a market cap of $134 billion. The free cash flow is up more than 75%. This is very important to me because the free cash flow is used to do acquisitions, buy back shares, pay dividends, research and development, and pay down debt. So Sony has plenty of free cash flow to do so. In this chart, we see that the stock went up most of the time and is currently around the all-time high. In this year-to-date chart, we see some volatility because of everything that happened this year with the positive and negative news. The stock is no exception. I really believe in the future play of this company. Also because the PS5 is not fully launched yet because of the shortage in chips. The PS5 is one of the bigger revenue income streams, so this might be something to do some more research in. Luckily, the company does more than just that. You can see my full video about Sony in the link in the description. My price target for Sony is around $190, as we see in this chart. They are undervalued by 11% in my opinion. I think Sony is a great stock to own. They are undervalued, and with the PS5 not fully launched yet, there are plenty of opportunities for this company. Besides the biggest income stream not on full power, the other income streams are growing in revenue as well, so this is a great sign. I currently do own shares of Sony and I'm planning to buy some more by the end of this month. With the added shares by the end of this month, Sony will become my largest position. I started buying Sony in the mid-90 range and I still think this company is undervalued by 11%, as I said before, so it's a buy for me. My conclusion is that it's hard to find undervalued companies which are also great companies to own and capable to grow. The 3 companies I just showed you are great companies and also undervalued in my opinion. They do all pay dividends, so that's an extra bonus for you. I currently do own shares of AbbVie and Sony and I'm planning to buy some more. I'm feeling really comfortable owning these companies. I don't own shares of Tyson Foods, but I'm planning to buy some shares and start my position at current prices. In my opinion, all the 3 stocks we just discussed are a buy right now. But remember to always do your own research and never fully trust on what I or other YouTubers say about a stock. I'm not a financial advisor and this content is just for entertaining purposes only. I hope you liked this video and I did bring some insights of the company to you. I would really appreciate a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to get notified when I'm posting a new video. Thanks for watching and I will see you in my next video.